Last summer I had uploaded this video saying that Windows 10 terminal will be better than any Linux terminal, and of course this video got hugely downvoted, although that was mostly because my super cute voice hadn't been invented yet, but also because the Linux community doesn't really love reality. And let me downvote it too, to make them happy. That video was referring to a very specific feature, and most specifically to the non-terminal views through community plugins. But the reality is, what you're expecting to happen when a project has 5,000 forks and 800 pull requests inside a few months of life? And those numbers are for a motherfucking terminal app, which is crazy insane. And if you checked on pull requests, most of them are from individuals rather Microsoft guys. At some point I had made some ridiculous mockups for Tilex that were showing different colors per tab, because this is a feature I really wanted to have on terminal. And so, when I saw the same feature on a pull request on Microsoft terminal, I had no other choice but trying it, see how it works, and of course upload a demo for you, that you will again downvote. But you know what? Fuck off, and enjoy! Keep in mind this is work in progress, it is not merged on master, but it already has been reviewed by terminal maintainers, and it is a feature that most likely will arrive on the next releases. By the way, transparency and some other stuff are missing, because dev builds have blank settings, and I didn't bother to fix those. So, on right click we get an option to select a color from some predefined palette, and pay attention how the colors fade away on inactive tabs, so they aren't distracting. We can also set a custom color, and let me open the rest settings, in case you want to see how Windows 10 color widget looks like, which is awful because it is missing a color picker. Tabs colors aren't persistent, meaning that new tabs always start with the default color. However, we can customize specific tab color per profile from settings, which is another great idea. And now just imagine if Microsoft makes an open source Files Explorer. 30,000 forks and 5,000 pull requests inside a week, and in a month of files at better than any Linux file manager. People sometimes say that community size doesn't matter, but let me tell you, it does matter. And this is why GNOME was hugely improved after Ubuntu switched to it, without Canonical developers contributing that much really. It is simple. The more the users, the better the software. At least that happens in open source.